things are for just management things. Survival is drought resistant species are there. Naturally, drought resistant species are there. Number two, now by transgenic plants, those who can control temperature and maintain drought resistant system inside have been newly developed in transgenic biotechnical species. We are having that. And even after 10 years, I don't know whether there may be a special injection or any genal implantation or mutation can happen in human life, due to which they may say that the human being, a transgenic human, at least he should drink one water per month or one water per year. It is more than enough. He is also drought resistant, transgenic. It may happen in future. So these things are the various drought management system. In grace management, it is a very different science. There are five major components told by these people, like Red Fund, they have given five major things. One is to totally avoid prescribed burning, which they are doing now, dahana in farms. And number two, total reduction of fertilizers, total reduction of herbicides. Number four, rotational stocking rate instead of cyclic or standard stocking rates. Number fifth, to have a wholesome consideration and care for winter feeding process, without which production of more hay at the time of drought cannot be made possible. These things are purely scientific, connected with the ranging or the grazing management which is given to the other livestock at the time of drought. Then coming to rain. Rain is a divine blessing. Everybody is saying, somebody asked me, if you say rain is coming by our rituals or worships, then why rain is coming in Chirapunji, why rain is coming in Albania, Tanzania, Uruguay, Zimbabwe, who is doing rituals there? Then I told that whatever you do, good thing, that is a ritual, number one. Number two, whatever you do here, it is not only going to rain for you, it is going to rain for everybody. It is Vishwa Kalyana, it is for universal benefit. So ritual need not be a very systemic and organized physical or peripheral ritual. Number two, benefit need not be very much provincially captivated or limited towards your end. So rituals are happening, and ritual is the root cause for benefit for wholesome world. That's what I told on that day. Apart from which, we want to say about some rain. One is phenomenal rain. We know that water evaporates and the same water condensed into water drops come back as rain. It is phenomenal. Second is prescriptive rain is there, invoked rain is there, provoked rain is there, indicative rain is there. What is prescriptive rain? Each and everybody's moral responsibility to the nature that brings rain. Honesty, purity, distribution, service, disciplinism, this thing they protect rain. So this is second. Provoked rain is whenever we are doing, that's why I told in one seminar, there is no rain at all. We don't get the real rain. We get rain whenever we are having cyclones, typhoons, monsoons and seasonal impairment. We are not getting regular real rain. Rain has become a byproduct. Instead of being a direct feed, it is now residing as a byproduct for seasonal errors, misbehaviors and celestial accidents. So whenever there is a celestial accident, whenever there is a misbehavior, whenever there is your erroneous consequence, then only you are getting rain. So whatever you are getting in the form of rain is a punishment, not nourishment. So that is the second thing. So prescriptive raining is by our characters. Provoked rain. Provoked rain is through, there are two provokings. One is provoking by these accidents. Third thing is provoking by artificial rain and other things. Invoked rain is by prayers, I have already told. Indicative rain is there. A real person who knows the rainology or the Vrishti Shastra, he can clearly say what the rain indicates. It may be Kshama, Amaya, Kshaya, Arajaka, Kalaha, Yuddha, Parikrama, Divya, Anugraha. It may indicate the arrival of a person, departure of a person, anarchy inside a country, monarchy inside a country, democracy inside a country, freedom inside a country, chaining inside a country, liberation of a person or liberation of a kingdom. It may also denote internal conflicts, external wars, arrival of new diseases. Somebody asks, what is the creativity of human beings? He has created lot of new disease-causing species, and he has improved pandemics and new diseases and disease causing enzymes. This is the creativity of human beings. Due to lack of stagnation, drainage mismanagement, habitual mismanagement and environmental mismanagement, we have created two things. New species, dengue and this chikungunya. We may be knowing about chicken, not chikungunya. Now everything is new. New diseases. Whenever you eradicate a disease in the pandemics, a new disease is coming. Whenever you invent a new medicine, it is created with antibiotic resistance. Oh, you are creating a medicine. I will create my own resistance. It is also competing with us without any lab research work or without any PhDs. It is being done by this pandemic society. Pathogens, they are doing that. So this is the creativity of our things. So it may also create amaya, indication. So indication of rain that creates drought, famine, conflict, war, anarchy, monarchy, various things I have told. This is the indicative study. Certainly, I believe that one day we have to organize a seminar which may be interesting, mind-boggling, and there may be a lot of oppositions for that, and we have to face the challenges and answer them very comfortably. That is also there. So this rain has not been artificially made successful. It has been artificially made. Before 50 years, it came into account. And now we are also having China recently tested and brought rain at Beijing. Dubai they have tested twice, and Mexico it has been doing for several months. But what is the problem? It will totally spoil the climate pattern, the environmental wealth, the water resources and soil. Now recently you know that China had a good record of bird flu, in which all birds and human beings, they competitively died with each other. Everything is caused by only this thing. So using all of these vehement toxins like calcium chloride, calcium oxide, then dry ice, silver iodide, these things are very great chemicals or toxins which create a system of bombardment, a system of agitation and coagulation, which makes the water vapor to be absorbed into the micronutrient shell of this chemical catalyst, which is then condensed into the form of water. So it is very dangerous, and it is inviting death, either a gradual death or total annihilation in disguise. So real rain should be brought by good behavior with nature, good behavior with fellow human beings, good behavior with gratitude and magnitude towards God and His creation, loving nature, transferring mutuality, fraternity and interrelativity with co-inhabitants of the society, demarcated in the forms of caste, clan, religion, provision and language. These behaviors only can produce real rain, and science is going to believe that this is the only possible way after a few decades. Then coming into irrigation, farm irrigation, institutional strengthening, and now recently there is a possible way in which the joint participation method or the participation method of irrigation has been recently produced. Recently they have created a joint participant irrigation method which is conglomerated with technologies, new irrigation technologies, sprinkle irrigation, drip irrigation. The more we have become parsimonious with water, water has also become very much parsimonious to us. Water has also become parsimonious. So there is a competitive parsimony between both of the people. So technological developments for water storage, water movement, and infrastructure, water storage management and reservoir management is there. Then socio-institutional methods for removing the conflicts that is there for water sharing and other things. It may create conflicts in the society. There are a lot of water policy issues and water legal related issues are there. This is a socio-institutional method which we want to say. Then third thing is environmental. By applying environmental technologies, we can totally deal with good biodiversity. We can deal with the issues of water degradation and soil degradation. Economically, technology is going to help you for increasing land value as well as productivity of the land. So in modernization of irrigation, that is the irrigation technology, the first thing is environmental for degradation challenges, economical for increasing the productivity and land value. The third thing is socio-institutional, which is for conflict resolution, to create compositive and collective farming, as well as to resolve the policies and legal issues that are coming in land and irrigation. Technology is very much used. Apart from which, technical storage devices, like there are innumerable technical storage devices for irrigation. Chinese devices, about 300 devices are there. Storer, sprinkler, joint sprinkler, sensor sprinkler, innumerable devices are there which are connected with time analysis. They know about the time to sprinkle, quantity to sprinkle, different quantities required to sprinkle, seasonal sensation, which season, how to sprinkle, climatic reflection. There are four sensors. One is a climatic sensor, second is a seasonal sensor, third is a crop identification sensor, fourth is the quantity sensor, fifth is the time management sensor. Apart from that, to make it intermittent, to make it perennial, to make it with intervals, to make it rotary and disciplinary, everything is there in irrigation, modern technologies. This is irrigation. The final problem is drainage. Wherever there is drainage, you see there is a problem. It is very difficult to live with drainage. There is urban drainage problem which we are seeing at the time of rain. At the time of rain only we have to see the real beauty of a place is to be seen at the time of its rain. Real beauty is evinced only at the time of rain. So most of the cities, they reveal their Miss Universe or Mr. Universe status only at the time of the rain. We can see how it is mismanaged, how there is drainage managed. Industrial drainage is there, agro drainage is there, urban drainage is there, innumerable deficiencies that are causing stagnation of water, lot of inconveniences, warehouse and storehouse for innumerable diseases, everything is happening by that. There are three possibilities told by people which nobody is going to do. One is reconstitution a reconfiguration of the whole planning system itself. Already they have been planned in such an atmosphere where this awareness was not there, where this expansion was not there. Totally evacuate this.